Hello everyone, Goldablaze here, and welcome back to Meta Nightmare Ultra, a subgame in Kirby's Superstar Ultra. The quality sucks, the gameplay sucks, and the commentary, it's okay. But overall, it's hopefully an enjoyable experience and a good video. But I'll let you be the judge. There's a little thing down in the bottom left-hand corner of the video. It's called the like-dislike button. Rate my video, please. I'd like to really know if I'm doing well on this. Anyways, in the past three episodes, we have played Meta Nightmare Ultra all the way up to Cavius in the Milky Way Wishes subgame. And today we are going to be continuing on with that. We've taken about 7 minutes. It's taken about 7 minutes for us to reach Cavius, which is... Well, partly because we took a wrong turn in Floria, and also partly because we just sucked at heart. I just sucked when going through the heartbeat level. Whoa, that was odd. And it dropped food for me because that was a copy of some Stilux. How nice. Here we go, fight Bonkos here, I don't really know if I don't know why I'm singing or humming Saria's theme. I don't even know if I'm doing a good job at it. I'll let you be the judge once again. Stupid giant bug. There. Downward thrust into your skull. That sounds kind of evil or dark. Just like thrust the sword into its skull. Jeez. And now, here we go. It's the return of, not Master Hand, but Rambam Rock. We're gonna slice it up anyways. It's not gonna be Rambam Rock anymore, it's gonna be Rambam Gravel. Oh, what? Die. There we go. And now we go into the Mechia, I think it is, the level themed after Revenge of Meta Knight. I'm about to die, okay. Wonderful thing to know. I'm gonna go get the run-up then, because obviously I might still need it. Okay, this level's starting to get... Okay, like my helper a couple levels ago, let's see if I can make it through here without dying. I am an idiot that jinxes myself! Oh my gosh! Let's see if I can make it through here without dying while I'm going down thrust to my death. Oh, jeez, that was dumb. I'm gonna go hit my head against a wall or something, and just, that was dumb. And the bad thing is when you die in this subgame, you lose every single point in your sword, pretty much. It's one of the downsides of dying here. Didn't get the extra life either, that kind of sucks. Well, I definitely am losing on time for this subgame now. Ouch. I have enough of Metacrack, good. Ouch. That's what I was trying to do. Jump through them. There. Run over here. Get the eggs. Have some health. Run over here and fight Bonkers. Come on, destroy Bonkers with some ease. There we go. Bonkers is down. And we go into the boss fight against Heavy Lobster. Silver Edition. Oh good, he didn't use the fire this time. Haha, you can't reach me because I'm behind you. Oh, of course the collision damage doesn't really... He jumped over me! He jumped over my attack! That's not cool. That's the Heavy Lobster again. For the third time in this one sub-game. Jeez. I don't like how they make you... I don't like how this level puts you on top of a Scarfy, seriously. It's like they just wanted to be cool. I refuse to die again. Hit the rope star, it'll help me get to the end of this level faster. And decreased risk of death. Yeah, okay, seriously, there we go. Get into the minecarts. Just cruise along, yeah. Unfortunately, not that fast pace. You know what, screw the minecart. I can knock these things down myself. There we go. Warp star now to take me to the end of this. Oh no, I forgot to pick up the chicken. How? Oh, not chicken, turkey, whatever. How sad. You only get... Yeah. I got cut while I was healing. Because I was looking at the bottom screen. That sucks. Die, you two. Jeez. Healing again because remember, if you're looking at the bottom screen, it's ample time to cook someone. Stupid Gordos. And Shotzo. Didn't even look like I was going to touch that one. Jeez. Get that one up. Go through here. Get a little bit of food. And it's time to fight Computer Virus once again. This is time instead of just the... Instead of Slime Puppet and Magician, we have Magician, Evil Knight, and Great Dragon. Ouch. Okay, one more would not be enough to do it. It'll leave him with 2 HP, so... Let's hopefully... Oh, 4 HP... How did I do less damage than last time? Seriously, how did I do 2 less damage? That doesn't make that much sense to me, honestly. Oh, you get the first attack, huh? Ouch. That's a pain. Well, here we go. I spent like 15 minutes here in... Yeah, 15 minutes in the Great Cave Offensive here. That's not great. Oh jeez, I'm just failing at everything. Great Cave Offensive. Jeez, this doesn't look like the Great Cave Offensive. No, because the dragons aren't in the Great Cave Offensive. Jeez. I have been at Mercury Ray Wishes for 15 minutes. Joy. I'm definitely not breaking any records with this one here. Five. Petrification is useless when you only have 5 HP left. Anyways, once again, like the Great Cave Offensive, you have to sit through this all over again, which really just kind of drives up your time. I didn't see it. Do the mask shine one. I really like the masks. The mask shine one. Anyways, here we go. Meta Knight now has assembled the 7 stars, which go and actually reassemble Nova, which definitely shows you this does take place after Mercury Ray Vicious. And now, ready. I will grant you one wish. My only wish is to become stronger. So I wish to fight the greatest warrior in the galaxy. Okay. You will now fight a warrior who was sealed away for fear his power was too great. I will now summon this great warrior once more. 3, 2, 1. Go! And I present to you the final boss of the subgame, Meta Nightmare Ultra. And he's a tough boss. For we are going into battle here with... Galacta Knight. This legend was sealed away long ago because of his power. He defies time to challenge you. Basically, Galacta Knight is a souped-up Meta Knight. And also, Galacta Knight is the only thing, the only boss in the game that I've seen that resist the Mach Tornado with surprising ease. Like he only took like he only takes like maybe not even a quarter of his HP in damage. Anyways, what he does there is he'll summon enemies, he'll summon the Meta Knights as little decoys while he leaves the field so you can go and restore points to your shield. Anyways, he fights with the Lands, has a mask similar to Meta Knights except it has an extra slit in it. And I think he can also shoot a beam from his shield. Ah, darn, he's summoning more knights. Ouch. Hey, no fair hit him, I needed to heal. Anyways, he is almost down. Oh, he didn't even really show off all his moves. Woohoo! Galacta Knight is down. Never lost to him in the Meta Nightmare Ultra subgame. But there we go. He blew up some, but really, he's not dead. He'll be back. And now that Meta Knight has defeated the greatest warrior in the galaxy and stripped him of his title, Kirby himself has now become the greatest warrior in the galaxy. Because he's beat Meta Knight. There we go. 17 minutes, 38.64 seconds, which actually I think maybe isn't as bad as my other previous attempts, because I came out at the very end with 47 minutes, 58.76 seconds to beat this subgame. Yes, it's a very long subgame, but a very fun subgame. And now, it's time for, once again, the credits. For Meta Knight has achieved his goal to become stronger, though Kirby already took his title of Strongest Warrior in the Galaxy away. Now using the same credits music, we pan up into space once again to see a more little kind of blue tinted scenes, I guess. They're not really cutscenes this time, they're more just kind of random things. I'll still tell them to you though, just my interpretation. Well, there's Meta Knight standing on the cliff just like he was at the start of this cutscene. And look, there's Kirby, haven't seen him for the past 3 episodes, and he's just kind of sleeping on his warp star, and Meta Knight's just flying through the air there. And there's King Dedede being thrown out of his castle again, while Kirby's being hit on the head by an apple after Dynablade sliced everything in half. And Kirby teaching Dynablade's tricks how to fly. Then Meta Knight talking with Dynablade there. And then Meta Knight teaching Dynablade's tricks how to fly instead of Kirby. I guess Kirby got fired from that job. Sorry, Kirby. There's Kirby happy with all the treasure that he found in the Great Cave Offensive right there. And Meta Knight just flying through the air. I guess he's happy to have wings. Kirby trying to approach the Halberd on his rope star while Main Cannon number 2 charges up to fire him down, and Kirby getting knocked off the Halberd after it initially started up. Meta Knight standing in the bridge with his crew and then attacking Really Rider Kirby and the Really Helper as they try to escape the destroyed battleship. And then Meta Knight standing on the deck of his battleship, all triumphantly. And then Mox taunting Kirby. A very dark moment in this game, I do say so myself. And then Meta Knight himself at the Fountain of Dreams. Perhaps he's making a wish or just wanting to dream of something? Who knows? And then Meta Knight and Gelatinite. And then Meta Knight flying triumphantly back home to Popstar. And, oh my gosh, he took off his mask and he's looking the other way, darn it. Oh well. Maybe next time. So there you go, that was the Revenge of Meta Knight subgame, but even though the credits are playing for the second time in this LP now, there are still 2 episodes left for. We still have the Helper to Hero subgame along with the nostalgic minigames to take care of and show off. And then, something else. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I won't spoil it for you. If you know what I'm talking about, don't spoil it in the comments. Okay? And more. That's what it's saying here. Basically, we get the bonus movie Fly Meta Knight in the theater. It's basically the opening cutscene, but with Meta Knight, which I'm not going to show pretty much, I'm sorry, but it's rapidly changing between bottom and top screen, and I've attempted to film it before, and I downright sucked. However, I do now have the other nostalgic minigame, Samurai Kirby, unlocked for beating Meta Knight Mio Ultra. Anyways, now having beaten Meta Knight Mio Ultra, I will be ending this video here and starting with Helper to Hero next episode. So, this is Gardeblaze, and I will see you next time. So long.